In this exercise, we're going to ask you to create an AF database and then create a specific structure. And that structure is going to look like this. It's going to have elements and element references. And we'll start with a production line that defines what kind of physically, you know, how the flow works. So we've got a production area and a production line one. And within that, we've got a couple of these mixing tanks. Now, in addition, we want to create a structure that the instrument people, the maintenance folks, can look at. So these, you know, what are these? These are tanks. So we've got an equipment maintenance view that has a heading simply called tanks. And there's a couple of, we have these mixing tanks organized under there. It's the same mixing tanks you see here. If you delete one here, it'll delete over here, of course. And if you make one change here, it'll change here. It's the exact same thing. It's just organized in two different places, or it appears in two different places. And in fact, when we do this, these will be element references. You'll notice these will be element references here. We're simply going to be referencing this element here. Now, I don't want to let the opportunity go to mention the type of references we're going to be making between these right here, these kind of parent objects here, and the children objects that are underneath here. If you recall, we discussed a reference type, and there's either what was called a composition type, strong, or weak. Well, we're going to use the default, which is the parent-child, which is also strong. It's the strong type. Okay, so between this object right here and this object, these objects down here, that's going to be a strong reference, a parent-child reference. Okay. And what that means is that essentially, when this parent is deleted, if it is the last strong reference to the children, if there are no other parents, if that those children have no other parents, then those children will actually be deleted. Now, in this case, though, we're actually going to be having two parents for these child elements. The child elements here are going to also have a parent-child relationship with this element over here, and that's going to be a strong relationship, or a strong, you know, element reference. And so what that means is that if you do decide to delete this, those elements will not be deleted, because there is still going to be at least one parent for these elements. And that's what this, that's what the we mean by a strong relationship. Now, if these had a weak relationship, and between this parent and these child, then if you deleted this, this parent right here would delete the children in both places. But in this case, since we're having strong, then, you know, once you have once you've got that strong parent-child relationship defined, all the parents have to be deleted for those elements to be deleted, for the child elements to be deleted. So that's kind of parenthetical. It's not real critical, but I didn't want to go without mentioning that again. That's something that it's not used a great deal, but it's an option that's available to you. Now, we're looking at this class workbook here. And like all the class workbooks, it's got a nice step-by-step solution, but also it's got a nice warning at the front. Please don't use the step-by-step solution unless you've tried it first yourself. You will notice that there's an approach section at the beginning of each exercise, so see if you can use that first. And if this is really confusing, you're saying, hey, where's this workbook come from? I don't have any workbook. This workbook is available to you from the main menu where you started your computer-based training. So if you haven't downloaded it yet, that is available to you for download. So go ahead and just download that, open it up or print it out, and you've got your workbook. Okay, go ahead and pause the video and give it a shot. And then when you're done, come on back and take a look at the solution. Okay, ready? We start this exercise in the Pi System Explorer. First thing we have to do is connect to the right AF database. So I'll choose the database option here. I'll go out and make sure I'm connected to the proper database. I actually have two in this network environment I can choose from. The one I'm going to use is this one that's local for me. It looks like I'm already connected to that, but if you had not been connected, you would just go ahead and choose Connect to make sure you are connected, and then select and then create a brand new database. Now just be careful you don't select or overwrite or delete this configuration database. Remember, that configuration database is what we use for internal things that are stored from the client application. So internal to OSIsoft is what we store in configuration, mostly client settings. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a brand new database called OSIsoft Plant. Of course, in your situation, if you want to call it something a little bit more appropriate, instead of OSIsoft Plant, you can do that. This is going to be OSIsoft Plant. This is going to be a test for the CBT exercise. And we'll go ahead and say OK. And that should create a brand new AF database. AF database that at this point should be completely empty. If we look up here, we see no elements. If we go down to the Navigator pane, look at Library, there's no templates, etc. So a brand new AF database. I wanted to start with two elements at the same level. One was called OSIsoft Plant. The other was Equipment Maintenance. So what I'll do is I'll just choose from here, I can choose right mouse click and choose New Element. And in the dialog box that appears, well, since this is at the highest level, you'll notice there is no option for the reference type. Reference type is going to always be parent-child at the highest level. So this creates my element, and I need to change the name of that element. I was going to call this first one OSIsoft Plant. And then we're going to create a second one at the same level. That second at the same level is going to be called the Equipment Maintenance. So there's a couple ways I could do this. I could go up here and do a right click and choose New Element. Actually, if I'm here on this level, if I choose New Element, it'll be at the same level as the current element, which is what we want here. So that's going to be called Equipment Maintenance. And I'll go ahead and check these two things in. There we go. We can check these in at any point to commit that to the AF database. Under OSIsoft Plant, I'm going to create an element called Production Area. Underneath here, I'm going to create Tanks. Now, this is the first time when we do one of these new elements that we have the choice to do a new child element. And I'll go ahead and create that new child element here. And when we, as we've done each of these, you notice we've left the element template blank. We're just going to use no template in this case. We have no templates in this AF database. We just created it. So I'm going to go ahead and choose the strong reference there, that parent-child reference. And this element is going to be called the production area. And in the equipment maintenance element, I want to create a tanks. I'll do a right-click here. Let's choose a new child element. The child element, again, no element template. We'll just choose the parent child, that's the strong reference. And this is going to be called tanks. So far so good. We've got the structure looking like what we've called for in the exercise. Now we need to add a couple of these mixing tanks and the storage tanks. We'll do that underneath the production area first, and then we're going to make reference to them over here in the tanks. Now I almost forgot, we need to add a production line 1 underneath the production area. So I'll right click, choose new child element. This is going to be called production line 1. Same strong reference, no element template here. Now under this production line 1, we want to create these two tanks, a mixing tank 1 and a storage tank 1. And the way we do this in the exercise, we demonstrate this in the exercise by choosing new child element. And just as we had done before, we'll call these, we'll do these one at a time. What I call this mixing tank 1 and storage tank 1. But you know what, we've done this so many times, let me show you another way we could do it. Remember, if you hold down the control key, you can copy these elements. So I'm going to hold down the control key, click and then drag this. And as you can see, it's created a duplicate of that element. It incremented the name, called it mixing tank 2. Let's change this to storage tank 1. There we are. The only thing that remains in this exercise is to make references to here. So we're going to do this as an element reference. When I do a right click here, we'll do a new element reference. So we'll choose add element reference. We'll go out and browse for these specific elements, mixing tank 1 and storage tank 1. So let's do this twice here. There's our mixing tank 1. I'll go ahead and say OK. We're choosing that same parent-child relationship. And then we'll also add the storage tank 1. We'll do a new element reference. And we could have done both of those at the same time using that search. There's storage tank one. Yeah, we're going to make that reference a parent-child reference. That's what the exercise calls for. And once this looks good, we'll go ahead and check all this in. Choose check in. That commits everything to the AF database.